shown you. DIYs with your old clothes and shoes. So we're going to be doing the tops first.
So now let's move on to the materials.
So you'll need as many tops as you like. I will be doing the slip back and the muscle tee.
I will be doing the tied up tank and the fringe top.
So for those tops you will need scissors and cutting board. Also another cutting board so you can put it through the top. So now let's get started.
Start by doing for the tied up tank is just cut the sleeves off. And then what we're going to do is carefully stretch it.
So what we want to do is try our top one.
We want to get our scissors. We want to measure to see how long it is. And you want to see how high you want your tied up part to go. So what we want to do now is we want to cut a straight line up to there. Okay, and then we want to make like a little triangle. So we cut outwards. So now your top should look like this. And we want to cut these side pieces off. And then we want to cut the back part.
Now you're done. So for the slip back tee, you want to cut off the sleeves. So once you've finished cutting it off and stretching it, you want to try it on. And then once you've tried it on, you want to get your mini cutting board and stick it through the top. This will help it not cut back the front. So to do the slits in the back, you want to poke a hole in it and cut along. Do as many as you want all the way down the shirt. And now you've finished. Let's get some
and live while we young. You want to cut off the sleeves. And then you want to put it on and measure how tall you want your fringes to be. And then you want to cut along all the way up to where you want them to go. So once you finish cutting them, you just want to carefully tug on them and then they'll kind of curl.
And you're done. So for the tank top, all you want to do is cut off the sleeves. Then you're finished. So now we're moving on to the shoes. I'll be doing Galaxy ones
and I'll be doing the American flag.
So for this project, you'll need white canvas shoes or black. Brushes and fabric paint or fabric markers.
For my American flag shoes, you'll need stars.
And for the Galaxy shoes, you'll need a toothbrush and a sponge.
And you'll also need tape.
So let's get started.
Shoes, what we want to start by doing is getting our tape and putting it around the sole of the shoe so that it doesn't get anything. What we want to do for the starting part of the American flag shoes. Because we want to put a bit of tape on the... Well, we want to make stripes. So we want to make stripes across this part, but not the front tip of the shoe. So now we're going to paint our shoes. So now when you finish painting it, just let it dry. While it's drying, add your stars on. And then what we're going to do is we're going to get our blue fabric paint. And we're going to carefully dab it onto a tea towel or a scrap of fabric or something, so then all the red or the color that you're using comes off. Okay, so now we want to get our blue and we want to dab it in like a going motion and just dab it around the stars, and you might need to hold the stars down. So this is one of the painted shoes, and that's the finished look. Attempt to close the door. So you want to start off by taping the soles of the shoes. And remember to take your laces out. So I'm going to start off with black, because I have got black canvas shoes. Start dabbing it. Only a bit, because we're going to be using lots of different colours for the galaxy. And I'm going to add some of my sparkly black that I've got here. Dab it around so it makes a galaxy circle. So once you've finished your galaxy shoes, the print that you want them, you want to get your toothbrush, and also sorry because outside started raining, so we had to come inside, as you can see. Hope the lining's okay. But so now you want to get your paints, make sure they're white or silver, anything you want. Put it on the toothbrush. Start flicking it onto the shoes. This will make the starry effect. And now you are finished. So now we're going to be doing our shorts.
So the supplies and materials that you'll need are scissors,
a marker or a pencil, a pair of jeans or shorts, and a tub of water. So let's get started.
So you wanna try your pants on, and we wanna measure an inch above the knee. And mark a line there. And remember, we wanna make them long, so then if we cut it as short as we want it, it'll be too short and it won't turn out. So we want to cut it longer. So you want to start off by cutting our shorts on the line that we marked. So I'm going to do that and keep the scraps, because you can try out new designs and things that you want to do on the actual. So I'm flip this over, and I'm going to cut. So now you want to cut your shorts to the length that you like. So now we're going to go on to Belle's shorts.
So now I'm going to use a pencil, try my jeans on, and mark him just below, well, on top of the knee, sorry. I'm going to work our way upwards slowly to the size where you want your shorts. So once we've marked it, you want to cut it where you marked it. So now you want to go back and mark them to where you want. We're going to go slowly upwards, so I'm going to start here. And we want to cut in a kind of diagonal, sort of.
So now it's time for the bleaching. So now you just want to dip them in the bleach, to about halfway of the shorts. And you just want to keep them in there for about a minute or two.
If you have dark denim jeans like ours, you want to keep them in the bleach for 2 to 3 hours. So now, when you get the colour that you want to rinse your shorts out.
So now it's time for my shorts. I'm going to put them all in and then for 10 minutes, and then I'm going to see how the colour turns out.
So I've just washed mine, and this is what it turned out to be like.
We hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe to Belnita. And as always, leave a comment below which DIY was your favourite and ideas for future videos. See you guys next week.
Bye.